I'll be showing the assignment drill downs and the grade drill downs and insights in Microsoft Teams. So I'm going to go here into physical science and I'm going to click to drill in. What you see now is the dashboard for the class. These are the assignment drill downs and the grade drill downs. These are really interesting. So for assignments, you get a high level 14 missed submissions, and that's down 16 fewer than last month. That's good. And if I can drill in here, I say check assignment status. Now I've drilled into the assignments view and you can see the different assignments I've made. And to think about how to read this data, it's almost like a little funnel. There was the assignment, and then it moved into the who viewed that assignment, then who turned it in, and then has it been returned by the teacher. And then there's some stats. On-time assignments, late assignments, multiple means multiple submissions. And so this is really helpful at a high level. And any of these numbers I can drill in on. If I want to drill in on here and say, well, let's look at some of this data. This is that same type of funnel. So I start with where it's been assigned, who's viewed it, turned in, returned, on time, late, and you get the idea. So it lets you drill in and see the list of each of the students for each of those assignments. I'll close that. Now I can also filter by student. So I drop this down and we'll look at Terry Klein here. Now the view is just filtered to Terry, which is really nice. I can see for Terry the different assignments, where they've been assigned, which ones have been turned in or returned, and the different stats. And if I want to pull back assignments from a previous time period, I can say load more assignments. So I'll go back and drop this and choose all students. And I want to pull in assignments from a little bit further back. I'll click load assignments. And you can see it added a couple more right into the stack here. So all these assignments are a little bit older, but it lets me see patterns that go further back. I go to the dot, dot, dot menu. I can get help on this graph here in these charts, and I can export this entire set of data to Excel. And let's hit the back button. And now what I'm gonna do is the average grade. So some insights today, 1 point higher in the last month on average across my class. Let's look at the grade distribution and trend. I'm here in the grades view. And what this shows is, first off, what's the class average? And this is just during this month, so I'm in November right now. And you can see some of the scores across the class. There's lots of different options to filter. First off, I'm gonna drop the date filter and I can go back 30 days or 60 days, 90 days or custom. I'm gonna choose 90 days. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop this distribution view right here and I'm gonna look at the trend view, which is a little bit different. So that shows the distribution. Now this shows the trend and you can see this dot by dot and I can really track exactly what was happening. 12 assignments returned, what was the class average? 8.2 out of 10, the high of 10, low of 5. So the trend view is really slick. And I can filter by students as well. So this is all my students. Maybe in this case, I want to filter on Terry Klein. Now you can see Terry here started pretty low, 4 out of 10. And you can see the average for the class was a bit higher, but then Terry really kicked it up and now she's turning in more assignments. She got 9 out of 10. She was above the class average. So some really interesting ways to explore the data on a per student basis or at a class basis. And I can switch this view from trend view back to distribution view. So in this case, we're gonna see Terry compared to the rest of the class. So here's Terry right here, 87 average, and the rest of the class 83. And you can see where Terry falls compared to the distribution of the rest of the class. Really cool insights. I can also drop all assignments down and start filtering by specific assignments. So I wanna see the distribution on these four energy assignments right here. We'll do these. And you can see everything updates just for those assignments. So Terry's average is a little bit different and so is the class average when I filter by specific assignments. And just like before, I'll click the dot, dot, dot menu. I can export all of this to Excel or I can get help on that page.